In this short episode, we will be still working on the UI of our application. And the idea is to add a very simple tab bar to distinguish between important emails and not important emails. So whenever I click a tab, either it's important or other, the proper list of messages of emails is being fetched from a server and displayed in our application. So let's see how it's done. Okay, so the first problem with the current situation is that when we start the application, we display the message list right away. So instead of having just one list, we will have two lists, two views, two screens that display lists. So we can certainly reuse that widget to display both of the lists. We need to have a mechanism to distinguish between which list should be displayed and when. So in order to do that, we will refactor this code slightly, and we will add another widget called app, simply like a top level widget. And let's start with a stateless widget. Okay, let's quickly import proper packages. And now back here, instead of displaying message list, let's display the app. Let me import it. Okay, so it's blank because we need to use the scaffold. So basically, we just need to take this whole thing, the app bar and the drawer, and to move it to our new class. So I will just grab this whole thing. And in app, let me paste it. We will remove the parts that are not needed. Okay, now we need to add the home, which will be just a container for now. I'm sorry, it's body. Okay, it would be a good idea to extract the drawer as well to another widget. So let's just quickly do that. So I will say app drawer dart. And let me grab this whole thing. Okay. And now here, the drawer we will use, the drawer we just created, we just need to import it. And it works. Okay, that's good. We don't need this anymore. That's perfect. Okay. Let's display a very simple tab bar. So in order to do that, we just need to wrap the scaffold with a widget called default tab controller. So if you have just only one tab on your screen, you can use this approach. Okay, once we wrap it, we can add the tab bar, and it's located in the app bar, so in this area over here, as a bottom. And we just add tab bar. we add the required parameter, which is tabs. And here we simply create as many tabs as we want as tab widgets. And they can have either an icon or a text. So I will use text and let's say important. So yeah, that's just one widget. One tab. And let's add another one. Yeah, so now if it works, but nothing happens. So in addition to text, you can also use an icon. So let me quickly show you how to do that. So let's say people, and you have an icon on top, and I will just stick to the text, to the simple text. So now in order to display this, we need to use TabBarView widget, which takes one parameter, children, and this is a collection of widgets that correspond to those tabs in the same order. So the first child here corresponds to the first tab here, and the second widget defined here correspond to the second tab, etc. So in our case, let's just do something simple. Let's say center, and let's say text important. That's our first widget and our second widget. Yeah, so now by default it's the first tab, and when I click it changes to the second one. I can also swipe to have the same effect. Okay. So now the goal is to replace this with the messages, with our emails. Let's start with other. And I will replace this second widget with message list. Let me import it. As you can see, it doesn't work, because if we go to our message list, it's still based off the scaffold. So it's meant to be the first widget, but now this role is being taken by the app widget. So we just need to clean this a little bit, which means that we need to remove app bar. We need to remove the drawer, because we define it in the app widget. And we need to remove scaffold as well. So we don't need it. We can return the future. Okay. Now the message list returns the future builder directly. And if I change, it loads the messages on each switch, on each swipe. Oops. Whenever I change the tab, the list is being loaded. So that's good, but not perfect. Let's improve that. Okay, let's remove those imports, because we don't need that. There's one more thing that's pretty annoying, which is this delay. So I set it to 3 seconds. And let's switch it to something quicker. I will keep it because I would like you to remember that something happens here. And when we reach the point that we have the proper way of handling or fetching messages, we won't be using such things. Okay, so now let's go back to the app, which is now our main widget, the first one that's being displayed. And this widget displays the message list, but we need to have a list of messages in both of those tabs. So I can replace it, but if I do that, I will have the same list in both of those tabs. I don't want to introduce any patterns right now, but let's just quickly fix that with another workaround. So here we will be passing a parameter, and let's just use a string. So whenever we pass status with the value important, we will fetch important list. And when the status is other, we will fetch other messages. So now let's go here and let's add this parameter. So it's a string and it's a status. So just a short reminder, if you define parameters in between of curly braces, these are named parameters. And you can also set a default value, which in our case will be important. If you'd like to know the difference or different possibilities of defining parameters for the constructors, you can check my blog post about this, which talks about positional and named parameters in Dart. Okay, but in this case, we are just saying that if you don't specify status, it will be important, and if you do, it will be the value of the thing that's being specified. And in addition to that, we, by using those curly braces, we can now say the key, the name of the variable and the value, instead of just doing something like that, which is not very clear. You have to open the constructor to know which parameter corresponds to which value being passed. So by using this approach of specifying the name and the value, it's just more clear for the consumer what is the intent in this situation. Okay, so we have that. So now we have to distinguish between those two scenarios. And in order to, we will do that here in message list. So just remember that this is still a workaround. So we pass this, and here in this state, we can access the value. So I have to refer to the other class, the one that has the status. And I can do this using this a getter called widget. So in every state class, there is a getter called widget, which refers to the corresponding widget class. So now the browser needs to know that we are passing a parameter, but I want to be clear here, so I will be saying again that this is a named parameter, so status equals widget status, and it means that here I need to use curly braces and I need to say status with the, let's say, again, default value. So now the error should disappear, and it does. Okay, so now we have the status here and the place in our code where we fetch messages. So here we have the status, and we will do another workaround. So as you remember, this endpoint was created by us, and it always returns the same content. So I will create another endpoint, and I will just say that this endpoint has two messages, and I will just change import the titles. So I will say important one and important two, and I will generate this endpoint. So now if I click on this, I only have those two messages. Let's go back to the code. So here we will say that URL is equal If the status is important, then return this new URL. And otherwise, return the previous one, the one we had initially. And we will just pass this to the get. Okay, so now whenever the status changes, if it's important, the first URL will be hit by the get, and we will just get the two messages, and otherwise we will take the previous list. So let's quickly check this. So we are getting it here. We are passing it from the message list to our message browse method. And here we are defining it in the tab bar view, that the content of the first tab will be fetching the list with the status important, and the second one with the status other. So now if I click important, I should get only two elements. And if I click other, I should get the previous list. So this works. Okay. But this solution isn't perfect, because now if I would like to implement the refresh button, it starts to become pretty complicated, because those two widgets manage the state in an independent manner. And now in this configuration, it's quite difficult to tell each of those widgets to refresh the content. The other problem is that whenever I change the tab, the content is being fetched again. And maybe that's not the perfect solution. We complicated this code a little bit in terms of how the data is being handled. The next step would be to clean this mess with using proper patterns. And the first pattern we will use will be the block pattern or business logic component, which will be pretty adapted to this scenario. But before that, I think I will do one more UI-related video about bottom bar. So that's pretty much it, and see you in the next episode.